Hey guys, how's it going? Welcome back. So you've just received your Certificate in Financial Education results slip. It contains a mixture of raw marks and UMS score, but you want to know how does that relate to actual grades? In this video, we're going to cover it. Let's get into it. So on your results slip, you'll see a raw mark. This is how many marks you got out of 35 and 65, respectively. That will be converted to a UMS mark, and based upon the UMS mark, you'll be able to work out your final grade. Let's look at each of these stages. So in front of you can see for Unit 2, which was the exam taken in June 2022 last year, the grade you needed out of 35 in the Part A paper was 32 out of 35 for an A star, 28 for an A, 25 for B, etc. In terms of percentages, the percentage you need, this is remember for Part A, 91% for an A star, 80 for an A, 71 for a B, etc. Now, bear in mind this was the Unit 2 paper done in June 2022. So what about Part B of that paper? Now that was out of 65, and you needed 38 out of 65 to get an A star, or 58%. To get an A, you needed 51%, or 33 out of 65, 29 out of 65 for B, and so on. Now, how do you work out the total grade for the unit? Well, you add the Part A and Part B together, and you'll come up with a total grade for unit, in this case, 2. A star, in June 2022, you needed 70 marks out of 100, equivalent to, of course, 70%. A, 61, B, 54, and so on. Now, bear in mind this was a June 2022 Unit 2 paper. The grade boundaries are likely to change each session, and we can see this looking at the history of the grade boundaries. So this is Unit 1 on your screen, Financial Capability for the Immediate and Short Term, FCIS for short. And back in 2018, the March sitting, so that would have been obviously the resit, you needed 73 out of 100 to get an A star. Now that's come down recently, of course, to 72 in March 2022. To get an A from 64 down to 63, and so on. So the grade boundaries will fluctuate each exam session. For Unit 2, it's a similar view. The grade boundaries back in April 18, June 18, etc., 73 all the way down to 70 in the most recent sitting of this exam, 64 for an A down to 61, etc. Now, you might be thinking, why do the raw mark grade boundaries change each session? Well, it's to reflect the relative difficulty of the questions within each paper compared to other exam sessions. So, if the questions within a specific session are deemed to be slightly easier than those in the past, there will be a higher grade boundary, and vice versa. So, that is the raw mark. So, how do we convert it into a UMS mark? Well, or Uniform Mark Scheme. Let's have a look. So, calculating the grade for Certificate of Financial Studies, as we know, we do Unit 1 and Unit 2. Now, each of those units is graded out of UMS, or Uniform Mark Scheme, and each of these units is out of 190. So, if you get 100 marks out of 100 marks available, you'll get 190 UMS equivalent. That will be how much you'll get from your 100 marks. 74 marks will be 171, 66, 152, etc. Bear in mind, of course, that as we said earlier, these grade boundaries can change. And of course, anywhere between the grade boundaries, 171 to 190, you'll get given an A star. 152 to 171, you'll get an A, etc. Now, you might be thinking, what happens if I do resits? Well, the good news is that for the final unit grade, the best combination of your Part A and Part B are applied. So even if you do worse in the resit, they will keep your best performance. Of course, if you do better in the resit, of course, they'll keep the second of your two sittings. Now, when calculating UMS, the exam board see how far into the UMS boundary a raw mark is. So, for example, if a student has a raw mark toward the top of the raw grade boundary, is going to have a UMS mark towards the top of that band. So, for example, we can see for this example, for D grades, it's between 42 and 49 raw marks out of 100. Now, of course, if you get 48, that'll be very close to the grade boundary. So you'd be looking at maybe 112 or 113 UMS equivalent points. Of course, it's very important to note that the raw mark grade boundaries, as we looked at earlier, change each session, whereas the UMS equivalent will not change each session. So 171 and above will always be an A star. It just depends on what the grade boundary report says. Now, teachers and exams officers have access to the grade boundary report, which gives the exact grade boundaries for each sitting of each unit. So you might need to speak to your teacher or exams officer to get those exact grade raw mark boundaries. The UMS grade, as we said, do not change for each exam session. So far, we've looked at the raw marks and how they're converted to UMS equivalent for both Unit 1 and Unit 2. So, how do you calculate the overall grade for Certificate in Financial Studies? Well, you add whatever UMS you got from Unit 1, of course, the maximum you could have got is 190 with 100 out of 100, and you add what you got for Unit 2, likewise, 190 being the total maximum mark you could get. And then you apply it to this grid here. As you can tell, 190, 190, it's out of a maximum of 380 UMS points. If you get over 342, so you hit on average over 171 in each of the units, you will come out at the end of year 12, or whenever you do the Certificate in Financial Studies, with an A star. If you get over 304, which you calculate by 152 times 2, which is of course the grade boundary, the UMS grade boundary for an A, if you times that by 2, you get 304, which of course is an A. And likewise, you just go down the table. So, what you can do once you've got your score, your raw marks, and your UMS equivalent, you can see now if you've got access to the grade boundary report, whereabouts you will fall in terms of UMS equivalent. LIBF are shortly going to be releasing the case study. I'm going to be filming full evaluations of each case study as well as model answers. Make sure you hit that subscribe button and turn on the bell to be notified of these future videos.